his old team. The two managers met up in a Yorkshire TV studio and the fireworks began.
Well, I think that, truthfully, Brian is a fool of himself. I must be very, very honest here. I honestly feel that he's criticised Matt Busby, Bertie Mee, me personally, Norman Hunter, Peter Lorimer, Billy Bramner, Peter Story. He's criticised so many people in the game whose records stand to be seen. He criticised so many people. This is his style. If he wants to be that style, fair enough. But I think that is totally, totally wrong for the game of professional football. He says about honesty and things like this. But when you talk about honesty, if honesty is going to destroy the game, then you're in all kinds of trouble. I think you're doing the game a great disservice.
Yes, I would.
In other words, the accusation is that you're too ready to shoot your mouth off.
So now when you talk about...
I would agree completely.
Let me answer his question first. Let me answer his question first. He talked about winning the championships better or differently. Our record is there to be seen for 11 years.
Yes.
Right? The first 4 or 5 years, I've always said this, we played for results. The last 4 or 5 years, we've been the most entertaining side by crowd entertainment and topping charts with national newspapers and television.
Also, Don, the disciplinary chart.
The disciplinary chart.
You topped that.
We topped that once.
Well, you topped it for the last 2 or 3 years.
No. That's not true. It wasn't 100% right, I will agree.
Sorry?
It wasn't 100% right, discipline, on the field. And last year, we straightened it out.
Well, it was. You were at the top.
Yeah. But when you see, Brian, when you talk about coming to take the Leeds job, and you had all these things and all these worries about stepping in my shoes and one thing and another.
Which I had.
Yes, you had. But why? Why did you come from Brighton to Leeds to take it all when you'd criticised them so much and said, we should be in the second division for this, and we should do this, and we should do that? Why did you take the job?
No, because I thought it was the best job in the country.
Of course it was the best job in the country.
I was taking over the league champions.
Yeah, you were taking over the league champions. You were taking over the best bunch of players that you've ever seen.
Well, I didn't know about the players, Don.
You didn't know?
I didn't know them intimately like you do. But I know you were the league champions, and I was taking over the league champions. I wanted to have a crack at the European Cup this year.
Yes.
I think that was near and dear to your heart also.
Yeah. Yes.
I wanted to win it. I wanted to do something you hadn't done. Now, when I said, I think I said it to Trevor Cherry, actually, or most of the players, he said to me, what can you do that the boss hadn't done? You, the boss, referring to you. And I said, I want to win the league, but I want to win it better. Now, there is no other reply to that question.
No,
because you had won the league.
Yeah, but there's no way you could win it better.
Why not?
No.
But that's the only hope I've got.
We only lost 4 matches, isn't it?
I can only lose 3.
No.
I couldn't give any other answer. And no. I wanted to win the European Cup. I believe that it was just a fraction, Don. A fraction. I don't know this because I've not spoken to you. But I believe it was a fraction whether you took the England job or had another shot at the European Cup.
That is totally true, because I was so involved with the players and everybody at Elton Road.
Good lad. Now, I wanted to do that, and I want to do it better than you. You can understand that, can't you?
Yes. And I think if you'd said that to our players, then you would have got the message across.
I couldn't say that to our players, as you say. I couldn't say that to our players just as a bold statement. You see, when I went in there, there was friction. There was unhappiness.
What do you mean, friction?
There was unhappiness because you'd gone an unsigned contract.
No. But when you walked in, did you have a meeting the first day with them?
No.
Why?
Because I didn't think it was necessary to have a meeting the very first day.
So you were taking over as manager of a new club.
Yes.
And you don't call all your players and your coaching staff and your office staff together.
No.
And introduce yourself and meet them and tell them exactly what you feel and what you want to try and do.
Don! The first day I walked in, I came back from holiday and I did 2 hours training with them.
Why didn't you get everybody together?
Because I didn't think it was necessary.
Why?
Because I thought that I would do it more subtly and different instead of having everybody bang, bang, bang. They were all on edge. I was on edge.
So you could have put them at ease.
No, hang on. How?
By going in and talking to them.
Oh, talk to them? I took the shirts off the backs after they finished training.
I used to do that. I massaged one of
them. Of course. Well, that was my approach, of course.
But you didn't meet everybody the first day.
I shook hands and said hello. Met them.
Everybody? Did you go to the laundry ladies? Did you go to the office staff?
Oh, no. I'm sorry.
Did you go to the groundsman?
No, I didn't have time to do that, Don. It was players.
You must have had
to. I have to interrupt here because we're getting towards the end. I want to ask, what's your reaction to a board that doesn't back you up, that sacks you after 7 weeks?
I haven't had time to know them either. Just as I believe I haven't had time to do the job.